Let us go through some of the sums related to ratios in this video. So for your reference, there is one sum given here. From the following particulars pertaining to assets and liabilities of the company, you are to calculate current ratio, liquid ratio, proprietary ratio, debt equity ratio and capital gearing ratio. So sometimes you get under the heading like whatever may be the profitability ratio or activity ratios, they might give questions like that, or they might give directly to particular ratios. So here if you find there is a balance sheet given, so you have a liabilities column and you have asset column. So in liabilities column you have 5000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. So 100 is a face value, so 5000 is the equity shares. So 5000 number, 5000 into 100 you get 5 lakh. Similarly, 2000, you have a 8% preference shares, which is of 100. So that makes up 2 lakh. Like that, you have given all the liabilities and assets like land and building, plant and machinery, stock, debtors. So whatever the details pertaining to each ratios, we would be taking from this balance sheet and we will interpret like what is the financial statement of the company is. And if you find this is the total assets, so they see this usually in balance sheet you would get both tangible and intangible assets. In case if the balance sheet has got only tangible assets, the total assets can be obtained directly from the total amount, right? Only if it has got the intangible assets, for the tangible assets we need to subtract the intangible and then find out the net tangible, right? So very first one, the sum, they have asked current ratio. We know current ratio is the current asset over current liability, right? So we know that what are all current assets. Current assets are any assets where you can convert them into a money within 1 year period of time. Anything that within 1 year period of time you can convert that. Similarly, current liabilities, any liability which should be completed within a year period of time. So that is current. That is a short term where you have a 365 days or within 1 year period of time for the assets and the liability to convert that into a money or to pay them back. So current assets, it is all the short term money like your stock, debtors, bills receivable and prepaid expenses, cash in hand and bank. You can also include marketable securities. So marketable securities, you cannot consider that as a long term investment, right? Because marketable securities, if you find in the balance sheet on the asset side, so marketable securities are the current assets where you can convert them into a money within a period of within 1 year period of time. So marketable securities, in case if you are given in the sum, these are all called current assets, right? So we take the total current assets. So here you have 2 lakh 40. So according to the given sum, you have only this much of current assets, right? Stock, debtors, cash, bank and prepaid expenses. So we add all the amount, we take the amount from the balance sheet, we add them, we get 5 lakh. Similarly, current liabilities, you have creditors and the bank OD. So only these two items are given. So current liabilities, anything that where you are liable to pay, like your creditors and your bank OD, bills payable and any outstanding. Like how you have prepaid expenses in the current asset, similarly you have outstanding amount in the current liability. So here creditors and the bank OD, 1,50,000 and 50,000. So you get total 2 lakh. So current ratio is 5 lakh divided by 2 lakh. So we get 2.5:1. So what does it mean? So current ratio tells about the solvency or the ability of the company to meet their short-term commitment. So if there is 1 rupee of every liability, right? I mean, we can say that for every 1 rupee liability, the company is able to pay 2.5 rupee. They are in hold of 2.5 rupees. So they are in a fair, well and good position. So normally it is ideal that the company has got 1.33. Ideally, they say that, but it is always 2:1. But this company has got 2.5:1. So it is really in a very fair position for the company. So that is the interpretation what we get for the current ratio. So just don't omit current ratio is 2.5:1. You can even mention what is the interpretation that you get out of this ratio. The second one is the liquid ratio. Liquid ratio we otherwise call acid test ratio. So liquid ratio, you can also call it as quick ratio. So what is quick ratio? Liquid asset by the liquid asset or a quick asset divided by the liquid liability or the quick liability. So how do we find out the liquid asset? Liquid asset is there are certain items that we need to remove from the current asset. So if we remove that, then we get the quick asset, right? So what are all the items that we remove? One is the current asset minus stock and the prepaid expenses we remove from the current asset. So if you remove stock and prepaid expenses, that becomes a liquid asset. Similarly, for the liquid liabilities, right? Liquid liabilities, we have to remove the bank OD, right? Current liability, total current liability minus bank OD. So if you do that, you will get the liquid ratio. Actually, I have not continued with the liquid liability. So somehow I missed it doing it. Maybe you can very well do it. You have a total current liability. So total current liability minus bank OD you get. You get only the creditors. That is the only current liability you have here. So 1,50,000. So what is your total amount here for the liquid assets? 2,55,000 divided by 1,50,000. So whatever the answers you get, so that makes the liquid ratio. The next one is the proprietary ratio. So proprietary ratio is proprietary fund divided by the total tangible asset. This sum we haven't given any intangible. So this sum has got 16 lakhs total assets. So I am going to take all the total tangible. So that makes all fixed assets as well as current assets. So that is the total tangible asset. In case in your balance sheet, if there are some intangible assets like goodwill, patent or copyrights, trademarks, if such items are given, kindly remove the value of those intangible items, then can take only the tangible assets, right? And proprietor funds are none other than your equity share capital, your preference and reserves and surplus. Proprietor fund will not have debentures or any long-term bank loan, right? So that those are all called external funds, right? So internal funds or proprietor fund, we take only the equity share capital, preference share capital and the reserves and surplus, which are all internal earning, or we can call that as the retained earning, right? So you add all these. So we have 5,000 equity shares of rupees 100 face value and 2,000 of preference share capital and then reserves and surplus. So put together, we get some 10 lakh rupees. With that total assets from the balance sheet, we get 16 lakh. So for every 1 rupee, we have 0.625 of proprietary assets. So we say that for every 1 rupee assets, our liability is lesser than the asset what we have. So this is also, we can say that the company is fairly in a very strong position, because proprietor fund, it is all the money what the company get for the, I mean, it is something like a blood, right? Fund is a blood to a life of a company. But we cannot owe so much, because it is all the money which the company has to repay at one point of the time. So if the preference shares you need to give in the form of a preference dividend, or sometimes they might leave anytime taking the amount with them. And that is why we say that any capital, we always put them on the liability end. We'll never put them on the asset side. So it is a liability. Anytime that is the amount is at risk. That is why when you are designing a capital structure, you have to be very cautious when you are designing your capital structures, right? So that is about the proprietary ratio. So you get 0.625 is to 1. Second one is the debt equity ratio. So debt equity ratios, you can say whether you can call it as an external equity is divided by internal equity, or you can say debt divided by equity, right? Otherwise you can say outsiders funds divided by internal funds. So what are the debt? And so debt are your debentures and your current liabilities. All your debentures and your your current liabilities and even your bank loan, everything comes under this. And your proprietor funds. Proprietor funds we have already calculated. So all we have to take the external equities is your debentures, which is 4 lakh, and your current liability, which is 2 lakh. So 6 lakh divided by 10 lakh. So that makes 0.6 is to 1. So this is also a very fairly good position. So next one is the capital gearing ratio. So very important for the companies to understand. See, capital gearing. Gearing, you must know what is gearing. Gearing is maybe we can say that gearing, if you just go in a top gear, you can increase the speed available, right? That gives kind of a push for the company to propel themselves, go forward. So we can put in that way, where equity shareholders are the people normally invest in companies, and they wait for the capital appreciation either in the form of the dividend payment or through the bonus shares, right? So it is the value available to them that is what it matters. So equity share capital, how much is your outsider's fund? See, if you say preference capital you need to give in the form of a preference dividend. So if you are unable to give this year, maybe you can give next year, or next year also you are unable to give, you can hold for 3 years and then give cumulatively. Long-term debt bearing, fixed interest, whether you make money or not, you need, company has to pay the interest, fixed interest every year. Interest on interest also possible, depending on what kind of contract that you enter into when you are getting the debentures, right? So these are all the amounts. So when you pay so much preference dividend and you pay the interest amount so much, the fund available for these people will come down. So that is why capital gearing ratio, we see to it that how much, right? So here, if you see it is as a 0.75, so preference capital 2 lakh plus long term 4 lakh divided by equity share and the retained earning, we get 0.751. So it is only 0.75 it's going out of hand for every 1 rupee. So we have in the edge of 0.25, which is fairly a good state. So this is about the various ratios. So you need to understand the formulas, and see, there is nothing to memorize. You just understand the logical reasoning, and you just see the relationship, because ratios after all is a relationship. Find the relationship and then you apply that and you find out, it becomes easier for you. Thank you.